Here we have one of the finest flaked stone Clovis artifacts ever discovered. These beautiful volcanic glass specimens were dug up at Mount Shasta, California by Lady Nellie Thompson in the late 60s, early 70s. This one, as they all do that I've acquired, have strict provenance in that Lady Nellie Thompson sold them to a young lady that bought her collection. She's had her collection for probably 15, 20 years, and she's been selling them as Andara crystal specimens for that period of time, and these were left for the very last, as these were the largest and most beautiful and most expensive of her collection. I was very, very fortunate to have been able to acquire these. This is in the shape of a Clovis scraper, but it's a Clovis cash blade. This is a Clovis cash blade, as all of them are. I have two other periwinkle blue ones pictured on my website, antiquitiesoftheamericas.com, and on YouTube. And I also have a darker blue, kind of a cobalt blue one as well, pictured. And these are absolutely stunning Clovis artifacts. In October of 2020, I discovered a new type of paleo artifact, an effigy made out of flake stone that images two faces, human faces, one young and one old, and two mammoth images, one young and one old. And what we have here is a cool mammoth image. There's the eye of the mammoth flaked right there on this unifacial side. And then we have the hair, the eyebrow, if you will, or the hair above the eye. That's all been very finely etched. That's the etching that I also discovered on flake stone, that is patterned etching representing the hair of the mammoth and the hair on the head of the faces. Nobody had ever observed that paleo etching, patterned etching on flake stone before I discovered it back in October of 2020. This is a beautiful mammoth. Here's the eye. Here's the trunk here coming down on this side. Now, we also have a baby mammoth here with a more exaggerated eye down here, and this, its little trunk coming off of there. You can see its eye right there, and the flake delineating the trunk is on the other side of the piece. This is the flake side here. This is the unifacial side, except for that mammoth eye and the etching up above there. Beautiful etching. Yeah, so this side wasn't flaked much, but I believe this side was meant to view the artifact. And then this side was just beautifully flaked with Clovis flaking. And the shape of these and the flaking are identical to the obsidian Clovis cash blade I found at Bishop, California. And I picture a periwinkle blue one, very similar in shape, or almost identical in shape to this one, on my website, antiquitiesoftheamericas.com. And under the more box, I have a tab for photo gallery. If you go on photo gallery page 4, you will see a side-by-side of the obsidian Clovis cash blade I found in Bishop, California, just maybe 100 miles south of Mount Shasta, California, where these came from. And by the way, the obsidian one that I found does have etching, and I feel was likely made as a story stone as well. I just need to do a little more research on that. This one here is so beautiful. Here's the eye of the mammoth here. Here's the trunk coming down here. Has all been flaked beautifully. And then we have the hair of the mammoth has been finely etched all throughout here. You can see those etching lines. There they are. Very fine etching lines for the hair of the mammoth, but also for the hair of the faces. Very beautifully flaked. These were made to stand. These were made to stand like that. All of these were made to stand. Look at the eye of the mammoth right there, and the trunk coming down to the right, and all the hair on top of the head and the back has been flaked. Very cool piece. And then the faces are really good as well, but not super delineated. What we have here is a nose and a mouth of a younger face looking off to the left there, right there. And then we have an older face looking off to the right with the mouth down here. So the faces are not nearly as good as the mammoth imagery on this. Here you see a lot of etching lines there as well. And those etching lines are right here on this side. And this side here has a lot of etching lines for the hair on the face. And we'll turn it this way as well, because I think this, here we go. There's the eye of the face, older face, looking off to the right. That's the eye of the older face. And now we have the younger face with the open mouth here, looking off to the left. So the faces are a little bit more abstract on this side. This can be the eye of the face, the nose, and the mouth. And you see the hair above the head has all been etched there. Just a beautiful, naturally occurring volcanic glass. And before my discovery, nobody knew about these volcanic glass paleo effigies. I discovered these volcanic glass paleo effigies and observed them for the first time. And thus I have a good collection of them. They come from Indonesia, China, Arizona, and Mount Shasta. And the Paleoindians flaked these and etched these all over the world. They valued this volcanic glass so much that they did not make utilitarian implements out of it. They didn't make spear points or knives. They used obsidian glass, obsidian volcanic glass for that. But this beautiful volcanic glass was just reserved for the making of paleo effigies. That's it. It is just too precious a material. And they really revered and respected this material. And I'm sure that this was made as an offering at Mount Shasta, as all of these pieces are offering pieces. Here we have another mammoth now facing right. That would be another mammoth there facing right. And that could be the eye of it down there. And this is looking through the unifacial side. But this glass is beautiful. It just, every way you turn it, it just has different light reflection. It's transparent, beautiful colors. This one green, I have periwinkle blue and also cobalt blue. Just the finest paleo story stone facing mammoth effigy, Clovis at its very best.